Welcome to the third and final Nordic Combined competition in these Winter Universiades. It's a Team Gundersen today, and Poland are going for a third gold in Strbske Pleso. They've dominated the Nordic Combined so far, and let's see if they can make it 3 out of 3. This is how they go. There's a mixed team, as well as teams from Ukraine, Czech Republic, Germany, Russia, Japan, and Poland on the 100-meter hill. 90 meters is the K point. Ernest Yahin for Russia. Didn't go in the Gundersen. He was 6th in the mass start with 87.5 and 84, and that's a better leap for him. Tobias Seaman of Germany. He's a good jumper. That's his strong point, and that's a good leap from him. 96 meters. That's the best so far. Agury, Shimizu, 2013 individual Gundersen bronze. Can he get another medal today? He needs a good jump. That's not bad either. Around 90 meters. Just a bit short, but that's a useful jump from him. So the Poles just looking to go on and on. Mateusz Wantulok, a mass start bronze, 91 and 94 meter jumps. Let's see what he can do there. And that's pretty good as well. That's nearly 95 meters. 117.8. Also, after the ski jumping element, looks like the Poles are in a good position again, although their lead is only going to be 9 seconds and 14 clear of Germany. Should be a really exciting cross-country event in Strbske Pleso. It's 3x5 kilometers for the men, and that's how they stand. It's close between the top three. We're underway with Poland looking to go for gold again. They've been dominant here. Sisla winning gold in the individual Gundersen and mass start. And David Welde, silver in both of those events. Kupczak got the bronze in the individual Gundersen, and Wantulok for Poland. They're dominating, but it's going to be tough here because Yamamoto has taken the lead. He was third in the mass start. Only fourth overall. He's a good cross-country skier, is Yamamoto. Here's the change. This is going to be a real scrap. Japan want gold, as do Germany. Poland have got a battle on their hands if they're going to keep this clean sweep going. In the second leg, and Germany are ahead with Seaman, and it's a real battle between Germany and Japan, and Poland in contention, and the Czech Republic suddenly in third. Zeman just getting ahead of Shimizu. Remember Watanabe, he was fourth in that mass start. David Welde was quickest in the mass start, ending up with silver, and he's going to be the anchor leg for Germany. But it's Japan at the moment with the game in their hands. Can they hold on? In 2013, they got a bronze medal to Japan. Poland, no surprise, winning the gold. This is a wonderful battle. You see David Welde there, tucked in quite nicely between the two. Japan ahead. The three, very tight there. Remember, Poland started with a 9-second lead over Japan and 14 over Germany. That seems a long time ago, doesn't it? And David Welde, he's got two silvers so far, but there's a gold in sight. This will be a wonderful story for him. He's 6 seconds ahead of Watanabe. This is going to be a battle for gold. And the team of David Welde, Johannes Wasel, and Tobias Seaman, they might just get a first gold for Germany, and they're going to get it. And it's, what a story. David Welde, He was being denied by Ciesla twice, but this time Germany have it, and it's their first gold in any competition in this Universiade. You see how much it means to them. Germany with the gold, Japan 10 seconds back. They'll be pretty happy with that. No Poland, though. And it's Russia getting the bronze. What a competition it was. And Germany get the gold.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.